Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Machedo is the best.
I get in touch with people almost every single day. Every single day, someone or another gets in touch with me. WhatsApp or email or chat or Facebook, okay? And I'm not talking of known people. I'm talking of someone I do not know. Someone who has heard of me, someone who has watched my video, okay? And I'll tell you something I've listened to. People get in touch with me, obviously, for personal branding, for jobs, okay? And almost every single day, I listen to one reason or another why they were not able to get a job. Like when I ask them why you're not able to get a job, normal answers are, Loy, you know the market. Loy, you know politics. Loy, you know racism. Loy, you know how bad things are. You know how bad the situation is. Like right now, if you speak to anybody, 100 out of 100, the person say, Loy, right now, you know the situation, coronavirus. Okay. If you'd speak to them before the coronavirus, Loy, you know the situation, it's a recession. Before the recession, Loy, you know the situation, there's that rain, that seeding, that flood that was there. Okay. Before that, Loy, you know the demonetization that happened in India. Okay. Before that, Loy, you know this. So it'll go on and on and on. There's a reason for every single failure that they have. Okay, and if you speak to them before, if you keep going on and asking them, Loy, you know my education was bad, the college. Then before that, Loy, you know my schooling was bad. Before that, Loy, you know my upbringing was bad. And if all those excuses are taken care of, then they'll go on scientific. Because they Google search, Loy, you know I discovered I had ADHD. How do you discover? Yeah, I read it somewhere. You know, when you can't focus, it's ADHD, Loy. I read it somewhere. Wow. Wow. Fantastic. So because of Loy, stress. Okay. Then what I do is after listening to all this, I ask them, what about money? Okay. When I ask them questions of money, same. They'll give reasons. Loy, you know, I got cheated in business. You know, Loy, you can't trust people. Loy, you know this, you know that. Okay, fine. So what I do is then I go to the most basic, fundamental one. Most basic. I ask them, are you in shape? Most of the time, people are not in shape. Majority. No, Loy. They will say, Loy, I don't have time. Loy, you know, that dedication to the gym. Loy, you know, the gym is far. In a day and age today where you have access to every book on the planet, access to every free video on YouTube, access to every article, access to so many gyms, access to fucking information on your fingertips. Fingertips. Never in a day and age in the history of mankind has it been. When you go to the toilet, people take their smartphones and access to the world. Okay? Even after all this, people still give excuses. Still they give excuses. Oh, I'm not able to get in shape because of something. Here's my question to you. When will you stop giving these excuses? And when will you start taking control of your life? Okay, now it is coronavirus, right? Okay. So for you, the reason for failure is coronavirus, correct? Okay. Before that, what was it? Before that? And before that, what was it? So every time there's a reason, right? Could it be that you're not meant to succeed no matter what the situation is? Maybe the world is so rotten that you cannot succeed no matter what. Would it be possible? See, I'll give you a simple thing, okay? Right now there's coronavirus, okay? Fine. Are people making money? Some people around the world, some, if not all. There are, right? Some people, okay. There are some people who are not rich, but they're still able to capitalize. There are some people who are still finding solutions. There are some people who are still, you know, doing something or another. Like, example, look at me, man. Okay, I'm not trying to say this as a matter of pride. Just, I'm staying on a fucking island. I am staying on a fucking island. Small island. You know, you can go around this island in a car in less than maybe an hour. 1 hour, you can drive around this island. If there's no traffic, less than an hour. Okay? 1 hour. It's that big. I'm on this island, which is far away from the mainland. Around 600 kilometers away from the mainland, or 800 kilometers. Okay? And same people. You'll see the same people every day here. Everyone knows everyone on this island. Now, on this island, I stay. I don't have anybody who is my customer. There's no customer of mine on this island. The Thai people don't speak my language. The local population doesn't need my services. The foreigners who are here, the tourists, they obviously come here for holidays. Okay? They come here to drink, they come here to dance, they come here to have fun, they come here to relax. When they come to retire, nobody thinks about personal branding because they have left the corporate world. So I'm in a place where I can't hold a conference, can't meet for a seminar, can't talk to anyone. Okay? My entire niche that is there is online. Entire thing. Okay? Now, just think. Online, I don't spend a single penny on ads. Not a single. I'm not spend a single, even a rupee, you could say. Okay? However, I still am trying to figure out ways and means of being noticed. I write articles. I go to different social media platforms. I post videos. And if you check my videos also, some have 200 views, some have 300 views, some go up to, 10,000. Now, there's no consistency. Now, people watching those videos watch it for free. They don't watch it to pay me money. People reading my articles don't read my articles to pay me money. Now, even after doing all this, I have to get someone to call me. I have to get someone to call me. I have to get someone to ask about my services. I have to get someone to trust me where he pays me money. And I have to do this every single day. Every single day, I have to do this. Whether market is good, whether market is bad. Whether the internet is there, whether the internet is not there. I have to sustain and survive. Whether I'm sick. Okay. Now, let's assume there is the virus. Let's assume there is bad market conditions. Let's assume there is no customer for 3 months. And this has happened. I've not had a customer for 3 months. So what excuse can I give, and who can I give this excuse to? Can I give excuses to my wife? Can I give excuses to my friends, which I don't have? Can I give excuses online? Nobody gives a fuck. So even if I give an excuse, this coronavirus, Google's changed its algorithm. Who the fuck cares? Tell me, who the fuck cares? I can shout and scream to all these trees and nobody fucking cares. I have to figure out a solution. And if I go online and ask anyone for help, you think they're going to help me for free? They're going to sit and, Loy, these are my trade secrets of how I got traffic to flow. This is my trade secret, how I got customers. No, people online will say, you want my time? This is my service charge. Then we can talk. And the worst part is, I don't even know if this guy will give me anything worthwhile. Maybe he'll just fucking waste my time. So, what do I do? How the fuck do I do it? This is what you need to think, man. There are people like me all around the world who cannot give fucking excuses. You know, sometimes when I feel sad for myself, or I feel pity, or I feel upset, I look at these videos of these speakers who don't have hands and legs. There are some of these speakers, no hands, no legs, but they go around the world talking, speaking. I really wonder sometimes, they don't have hands and legs, how do they have bath? How do they wash their ass? How do they, eat food? How do they, if they want to have sex, what do they do? What kind of life is that? And these guys, they don't give any excuses. They live their life. So when I look at people like that, I'm like, fucking hell. If he can live a life like that and make shitloads of money, what the fuck am I giving excuses for, man? See, what I want to tell you is, there will always be challenges in life. There will always be fucking challenges in life. you'll always have coronavirus this, or recession, or depression, or it's all fuck all, man. It's all fuck all. It's all external. You stop giving all these fuck shit excuses, man. Just stop it. Just fucking stop it. Nobody gives a fuck about it. Nobody cares a damn. You want to go do something, just go fucking do it. Yes, you will fail. Yes, you'll fall flat on your face. Yes, you'll not get the results you want. But get the fuck up back again and do it. It's like these motivational fucking videos, these boxing videos, these gym videos, these movies. The guy falls down, the underdog, he gets up again. There is inspirational music and he goes out to do it all over again. The only sad fact is there's not going to be any fucking inspirational music. There's not going to be anybody who's going to shout and scream, and it's not going to be a feel-good movement. There's nobody going to make a movie about you. It's going to be quiet. It's going to be silent. You know, we normally focus on people who are successful, people who are like successful boxers and fighters and athletes. We look at them, oh, believe in your dream, achieve the impossible. Oh, when the person holds the Oscar, you know, the secret to my say, never stop believing in yourself. That's one fucking person out of millions. Billions, not millions. The rest of the people are going to fail. The rest of the people are going to be ordinary. The rest of the people are not going to achieve any of their fucking dreams. So, what the fuck are you going to do? You're not going to be a Sachin Tendulkar. You're not going to be a Elon Musk. You're not going to be a Jeff Bezos or Bill Gates or Mark Zuckerberg or Usain Bolt. You're going to be an ordinary fuck. All right? So, what are you going to do? Either you can be like those shitheads on, you know, who comment on my YouTube feed. Oh, what the shit is on his face, and they talk and they comment and they bitch about others. Either you can be like that. Or you can focus internally and ask yourself, what the fuck can I do? How can I make some money? How can I make more money than I made last month? How can I have a better quality life? Because nobody gives a fuck about you, man. Nobody gives a damn fuck about you. Nobody cares shit about you. You can give all the excuses. Oh, you know, coronavirus. Oh, market is down. Shut the fuck up, man. There are people who have made money when they were lucky. They made money because the market conditions were good, because things were favorable, so they made money. And they assumed, oh, it's my superior intelligence. It's my creative mind. It's my genius. It's my entrepreneur spirit. But then when times became bad to us, when it really tested their mettle, they were nothing. They were nobody. This is the situation of the majority of the business people right now, especially in the Middle East. They're fucked. Oh, the enterprising spirit, the entrepreneurship, their vision, their mission, all fucking put it up your ass. And put chili up on a dildo and then shove it up your ass. No, and what you do is instead of normal dildo, take a fucking stud, steel studded dildo, man. Hey, who the fuck cares? You succeeded once upon a time. Every day is a new fucking day. For me, every day, I have to get a new client. Every day, I have a target. Every day, I have expenses. I have no fucking salary. And it's not a single day where I don't get another fucking chute online. Oh, Loy, I have no money. Loy, I have no money. My mother's sick. My father's dying. Oh, my child is this. Oh, coronavirus. Loy, recession. Oh. Go fuck yourself. Because nobody's going to take care of me, my daughter, and my family. Oh, Loy, I'll pray for you. Pray for your fucking self. Oh, Loy, God will bless you. Go fuck you and your God and your religion and all that shit. Because nobody gives a damn. You need to survive. You need to sustain. Nobody gives a fuck. You want something? Either go and get it. If you can't get it, either employ the services of a professional to get it. Or go beg. Go beg somewhere else. Somewhere where people will listen. I've done everything. Beg, borrow, steal, cheat. That's the only way you can succeed. Like I told you, I'm staying on an island. A fucking island. Miles and miles away from anything. There is no conference center. There's no business hub. There's nobody I can meet here. There's no customer. There's no client. There's only villages. There's forest. I can't give excuses. Google has changed its algorithm. YouTube has not giving me preference. They can demonetize my video. They can make sure people don't. Many people say, Loy, I'm not getting updates of your videos. Well, what I can do? I can't do anything. So, but I have to survive, right? I have to make money, right? So that's what it comes down to. Make shitloads of fucking money. Be successful. Do something with your life. Stop giving fucking excuses. I've told you this. There are thousands, hundreds of thousands of fucking books on losing weight, getting in shape, articles, videos. If after all that you can't fucking get in shape and lose weight, then you're just joking with yourself, man. You're just joking, giving fucking excuses. All it takes is a drive, a desire, a willingness to not to fucking give up, but to keep trying till you fucking succeed. To hold yourself accountable to a very high fucking standard. For me, it's very simple. I have no other fucking option, absolutely no option, but to succeed. And that's what I intend to do. And I made it very clear, if I can't fucking succeed, I will kill myself. There's absolutely, absolutely no second thoughts about it. If I cannot succeed, if I cannot earn my livelihood, if I'm dependent on it, better I die. And that's a decision I took in 2011, which was my suicide video. So I hope this gives you some sense, some bit of recourse, some bit of hope that this positive thinking and faith and prayer and all this fucking gas, fine, if it helps you, good. But get your ass up, go and fucking do something. Life is not going to be fair. The market is never going to be good. Nobody's sitting there opening their legs for you to go and fuck them. You have to go get what you want. No matter however the fuck you can do it, just go and do it. Whether it's a coronavirus, whether it's a corona fungus, whether it's a corona bacteria, fuck all that. As long as you have hands and legs, you have health, your eyes, you have a mind, go and fucking do something. You're not in a war-torn fucking region, man. So shut the fuck up. There is an internet, there's a smartphone, there's a laptop, there's a computer. Don't give fucking excuses. Just don't give fucking excuses. Remember, 2011, I was penniless, homeless, without nothing, not even money to have one meal. From there, I started with nothing and nobody, and I achieved what I had to. I'm not saying this to beat my chest with pride. I did it because I had only two options. Either I kill myself or I'll succeed, one of the two. And I succeeded. Today also, I don't have any choice. No choice but to succeed. Nobody's going to take care of my daughter. Nobody's going to take care of my wife. Nobody's going to take care of me. So that's what it comes down to. So all I'll tell you is, grow a pair of fucking balls and start living your life, taking fucking personal responsibility for it. Stop being a fucking pansy. Have some fucking self-respect. And go out and get whatever the fuck you're supposed to get. I hope this video, first thing in the morning, gives you some bit of common sense, inspiration and strength to go on. Life is going to be fucking tough. Better accept it. Life is not going to be fair. There is always going to be some other new challenge. Embrace it fucking open arms, but make sure that you succeed. That's all I'll tell you. All right? You guys take care.